Good morning to everyone. Myself, I am Surya Narayana, working as an assistant professor in PBR WITS Kavali. In manufacturing process subject, last class we discussed about core and different types of cores, core box and core prints. Today in this class, we are going to discuss about gating system and what is gate, different types of gating systems and elements of gating system. Pouring time calculations we will discuss in this class. First of all, we want to know about gating system and what is gate. The term gating or gating system refers to all the passageways. That means gate is a passageway through which metal enters into the mold cavity. It thus mainly includes parts such as pouring basin, sprue, runner and gates, a riser. Okay. Remember that gate is a one passageway. Through gate, the molten metal enters into the mold cavity. Requirements for a defect-free casting. In order to avoid defects in casting, mold should be filled in a smallest time. If time is taken long periods, then the defects are raised. Next, metal should flow without turbulence. That means no zigzags, only linearity. Only one layer, that means in the form of linear way, in order to avoid defects in casting. Next, unwanted material should not enter into the cavity. Atmospheric air should be prevented and proper thermal gradient should be maintained. No gating or mold erosion. Erosion is nothing but corrosion, eroded. Rust formation should take place. Enough metal should be there inside the mold cavity. Economical and casting yield should be maximized. In this slide, I am showing that gating system. First of all, the molten metal is in the form of semi-fluid. Then that molten metal is poured into the pouring basin by using ladles. After then, the molten metal is passed through the sprue and then into the runner and enters into the gate. After then, cavity. Gate is a passageway. Through gate, the molten metal enters into the cavity. After then, riser. Riser is used to filling the cavity and escaping the gases through the riser. And next, coming to elements of gating system. Up to now, we discussed about only what is a gate and gating system. Why we are providing gating system in casting. And in this slide, we are starting and knowing about what are the elements of gating system. First of all, elements of gating system: pouring cups and basins, next sprue, and next runner, and next gates, riser or feeder head, riser extension. These are all the elements. First of all, I am starting with pouring cups and basins. Pouring cup is a funnel, okay? Pouring cup is a funnel shaped cup which forms the top portion of the sprue. Through pouring cup, we are pouring the molten metal into the cavity and it makes easier for the ladle or crucible operator to direct the flow of metal from crucible to sprue. Next, basins. These two are similar. One is in the shape of cup, It is a funnel and basin. Basin, the molten metal is not directly poured into the mold cavity. It is poured into the pouring basin, which acts as a reservoir. That means that is the difference. In pouring cup, we are directly pouring the liquid into the funnel. In pouring basin, we are not directing the molten metal into the basin. First of all, we are pouring the molten metal into the basin. That means it acts as a reservoir from which it moves smoothly into the sprue, after then runner, and then directed to gate and fills into the cavity. That is the pure difference between cup to basin. Next, it prevents the slag from entering the mold cavity. Slag means dust particles. Next, it holds back the slag and dirt which floats on the top and allows only the clean metal to enter into the sprue. That means it holds the unwanted particles in the molten metal and flows only the clean metal into the sprue. That is the main advantage of pouring basin than pouring cup. The basin is cut in various shapes into the cope directly. These are all about the figures of cups and basins. The left figure is about cup and right figure basin. Next, elements. Next element, sprue. Sprue is also a channel. It is the channel through which the molten metal is brought into the parting plane, where it enters the runner and gates. The passage is linkage starting with pouring basin, after then sprue, and then runner, runner to gate, gate to the cavity. Squares of 20 mm diameter, that means these are in the shape of tapered downwards to avoid aspiration of air and metal damages. Basically, sprues are in the shape of tapered sections. That means why we are preferring the tapered sections, because of avoiding the air and metal damages. Next, sprues are up to 20 mm diameter or round in section, whereas larger sprues are generally in rectangular shape. That means normal sprues are 20 mm diameter, and after then larger sprues are in rectangular sections. Rectangular sprues, there is a less turbulence. Next, runner. Runner, in large castings, molten metal is generally carried from sprue base to several gates around the cavity through a passage called a runner. Depending upon the shape of the casting, the runner may be located in the cope or drag pot. To avoid aspiration and turbulence, it should be streamlined. Runner is a passage. In larger castings, we are preferring runner. Next, gate. Previously, we discussed about gate. Gate is a passage way to flow the molten metal through it. The gate is a channel which connects runner with the mold cavity, through which molten metal flows to fill the mold cavity. The location and size of the gates are so arranged that they can feed liquid metal to the casting at a rate consistent with the rate of solidification. The gate should not have sharp edges, as they may break during pouring and thus carried with the molten metal into the cavity. Okay, sharp edges are avoided in gates. The gate should be located where they can be easily removed without damaging and the casting. Next, coming to types of gates. The major types of gates are as follows: parting line gates, bottom gates, top gates, side gates. First of all, I am starting with parting line gates. As its name implies, parting line which differs or dividing cope and rack boxes. These gates enter the mold cavity along the parting line separation. Cope and rack portions. We already know that the parting line which divides the two sections or two halves, cope and rack, along with the gate. It is the simplest form in nature and in construction. Such gates are commonly used and are found to give satisfactory service except when the mold is very deep. And next, this figure, I am showing that parting line gate. As its name implies, parting line gate which is at along with the parting line is called parting line gate. Next, top gates. Top gate is also called as drop gate because the molten metal just drops on the sand in the bottom of the mold. A top gate simplifies the molding with low consumption of additional metal. I will show in next slide figure of the top gate. The dropping liquid metal streams eroding the mold surface. It is not favorable for non-ferrous casting. It is only for ferrous casting. Top gate. It is a figure for top gate. The molten metal pouring from top section. And next, top gates are further classified as pencil gate, edge gate, next gate with a strain score, finger gate, ring gate, wedge gate. Those are the different types of gates in top gates. After then, coming to bottom gates. A bottom gate is provided in the drag half of the mold. Okay, the upper one is cope and below one or downside section is the drag section. So, in that place we are fixing the bottom gate in drag section. In this, liquid metal fills rapidly the bottom portion of the mold cavity and rises steadily and gently up the mold walls. Bottom gates provide less turbulence and erosion in the mold cavity. Why? Because the time for filling is very less in bottom gate. It is not used in large and deep casting because the metal cools gradually as it rises up. These are about bottom gates. These gates are fixed at drag section. Next, side gates. Side gates are provided on either left or right side of the casting. Hence, the metal enters into the mold cavity from side. Okay, see, observe the difference between top gate, bottom gate, side gate. As its name implies, top gate at top side, bottom gate is at drag section. Top gate is at cope section. Two halves are there, one is cope and the second one is drag. Side gate. Side gate is at either left or right. Hence the metal enters into the cavity from any side, that means left or right. It enters near the bottom first and then as the level of the metal rises in the mold, the incoming molten metal starts entering near the surface of the rising metal. This is the figure of side gate. This is fixed at either left or right. Next, riser or feeder head. First of all, we want to know about riser. A riser is a passage of sand made in the cope to permit in the molten metal to rise above the highest point in the casting after the mold cavity is filled up. This metal in the riser compensates the shrinkages as the casting solidifies. Functions of riser. The functions of riser as follows: to feed metal to the solidifying casting so that shrinkage cavities are got rid of. It permits the escape of air and mold gases as the mold cavity is being filled with the molten metal. The main function of the riser is that after filling the molding cavity by the molten metal, then exhaustible gases or air, those are escaped through the, after filling the molding cavity with the molten metal, then the gases are escaped through the riser. That is the main function of riser. Next, it promotes directional solidification. Also, it shows the mold cavity has been completely filled or not. Through riser, we can confirm the cavity is filled or not. Next, different types of risers. Top riser. It is also called as dead riser or cold riser. It is located at the top of the casting. Next, these types of risers filled up the coldest metal and are likely to solidify before casting. By using top riser, there is more saving of material as compared to other risers. This one is top riser. This is very economical compared to other risers. Next, side riser. It is also called as a live riser or hot riser. Top riser is known as cold riser. Side riser is known as hot riser. It is located between runners and casting. It is filled up with the last and contains the hottest metal. In top riser, we are using coldest metal in order to solidify. The risers are further classified as open riser and blind risers. This is side riser. Next, open risers. These risers are open to atmosphere at the top surface of the mold. Open riser, as its name implies, open. Open to atmosphere. The liquid metal in the riser is fed to the solidifying casting under the force of gravity and atmospheric pressure till the top surface of riser solidifies. That is completely open to atmosphere. Air enters through it in order to solidify the molten metal. It is connected to either at the top of the cope or on the side of the parting line. Generally, open riser is in the shape of cylindrical. These type of risers are easy to mold. Next, blind riser. Blind risers do not break to the top of the cope and are entirely surrounded by the molding sand. Okay, these are not easy to break at the top of the cope. These are completely surrounded by the molding sand. As it is closed at the top, a vent or permeable core at the top of riser may be provided to have some exposure to the atmosphere. It is also connected at the top of the cope or on the side of the casting of the parting line or in the drag. These are all connected. Blind riser is rounded cavity and it associates a slow cooling rate, also more efficient. These risers are difficult to mold. Open and blind risers. Okay, in this, I am showing that open type and blind risers. Open riser. Open riser is free to atmosphere. But blind riser is completely surrounded by the sand or mold. Next, chill. Metallic chills are used to provide progressive solidification or to avoid shrinkage cavities. In order to avoid shrinkage cavities, we are providing chills. These are all in large heat sinks. Use of chill will form a hot spots which needs further machining. Gating system design. After then, elements of gating system and risers, different types of risers, we have to discuss about gating system design. First of all, the design starts with pouring time calculation. Pouring time required for complete filling of mould cavity. If it is too long, then it requires a higher pouring temperature, and if it is too short, there will be turbulent flow which will cause defective casting. So the pouring time depends upon the casting material, complexity of casting, section thickness and casting time. These are all the parameters will based on the pouring time. Next, ferrous material requires less pouring time, whereas non-ferrous materials requires higher pouring times. For calculating pouring time, time T that equal to K into 1.41 plus capital T by 14.59 square root of W into S. In this, for grey cast iron, mass is very less than 450 kgs. K is the fluidity of section, T is average section thickness, capital T. W is the mass of the casting. It is for grey cast iron of mass is less than 450 kgs. Next, if grey cast iron mass is higher than 450 kgs, then formula is changed like T equal to K into 1.236 plus T by 16.65 cube root of W into S. For steel casting, T equal to 2.4335 minus 0.3953 log W square root of W S. For shell molded ductile iron, T equal to K1 square root W S. K1 that equal to 2.08 for thin section, 2.670 for 10 to 25 mm thick sections, 2.970 for heavier section, that is K1 value for shell molded ductile iron. Next, for copper alloy castings, T equal to K2 cube root of WS. K2 value constant given by top gating, bottom gating, brass, tin bronze. For top gating 1.30, for bottom gating 1.80, for brass 1.90, tin bronze 2.80. Intricately shaped thin walled castings up to 450 kgs, then pouring time is small t that equal to K3 cube root WS. K3 is constant above 450 kgs and up to 1000 kgs, pouring time small t that equal to K4 cube root WS. For mass less than 200, up to now we calculated the mass is 4000 kgs and below 4000 kgs and above 4000 kgs. Then if assume the mass is less than 200 kgs, average section thickness is 25 mm, then for grey cast iron 40 seconds, steel time is 20 seconds, brass 15 to 45 seconds. Then gating ratio, it is the ratio between sprue area to total runner area to the total gate area, that is sprue area to runner area to gate area, that is gating ratio. Thank you, students. Thanks for watching.